Good morning and welcome to the Kentwood 2023 Independence Day Parade. My name is Kathy Beatty. I'll be your host. Joining me is Mr. Peter Letzman. Happy Independence Day, Peter.
Good morning, Kathy, and good morning, Kentwood and the rest of the world. Welcome to the 2023 Kentwood City Independence Day Parade that we celebrate on the 4th of July.
We do. So we are looking forward to all of the people who have lined the streets. There are thousands out here, and we have a community, a great representation of folks who are joining us today. And there we are, starting with our color guard.
The flag bearers have the flag of the city of Kentwood, the United States, of course. And these are all veterans who are displaying their patriotism to the folks here at Kentwood. And this is the AmVets Post 2023, yes. Coincidentally, of in year 2023. And I have to admire these sort of senior citizens who are walking the whole parade route.
So why is this date such a big deal, Peter? For 247? Is that what we're celebrating?
Well, we are celebrating that 247th day with the members of the Kentwood City Council and the mayor walking right behind the flag bearers, the mayor, Steve Kepley, in the blue,
Jessica Ann Tyson and Betsy Arts.
And Bob Coughlin.
Yes,
and
Claxton Morgan.
The majority of the council, they have a quorum present. I wonder if they have posted that meeting as required by the Open Meetings Act.
I'm sure they're not conducting business. They are simply greeting this wonderful community, and what a glorious day that we have for it.
And we can't omit the antique fire engine that just passed us by, and here are the more modern fire engines, the equipment that the city of Kentwood has. We should note the cost of this equipment is tremendous. Those trucks, you see the hook and ladder, it's not the hook and ladder anymore, it's the ladder extension truck, upwards of $750,000. The pumper likewise is in excess of $500,000, and that is where your tax dollars are going.
And that's a good place for them to go, especially if you've ever experienced a fire, that's for sure. And here we have a beautiful float. I love it. I don't think red, white, and blue stands out any more clearly than it does on the 4th of July. Oh, we're handing out. Oh, here comes the candy. Always an important part of our parade. The kids are lined up waiting, some with bags, and lots of smiles, lots of sunshiny weather to celebrate.
I hope they have a good arm, Kathy, that the distributor can give us a toss of some of those goodies over here to our table.
We're
sitting out of the way. This looks like Kentwood DPW with their decorated truck.
Yeah.
Look at all of those decals or paintings on that snowplow.
Handprints. I love it. I love it. City of Kentwood Public Works. Thankful for them. Oh, here comes the candy, a little flags. Oh, the children will be delighted.
We're concerned about that DPW truck in the snow removal, and those folks here in Kentwood enjoy a prompt removal of snow, not only on the main roads, but on the side streets also. Thank those guys that work through the night.
For sure. Oh, there is Judge Sturkenberg, Amanda Sturkenberg, who is joining us today, and how nice to see the judge out here and waving to all of those people from the 62nd the District Court of Kentwood. She's been in the position for 3 years.
She took over Judge William Kelly, who and his father were judges in that for many, many, many years. And the new judge is not so new anymore.
3 years, yeah. So how wonderful to have her join the community on such a great, great day. Merle's Towing Service.
Now everybody knows Merle's.
Yeah. We've been helping the community for 80 combined years of service. Wow, I can't imagine how their trucks have changed over the decades. The Emergency Road Service offer plays an important role in keeping the roadways clear. Indeed it does. After accidents or whatever, we're going to get those vehicles off the road. And
keep that telephone number handy, so if you're parked illegally in an apartment or some other parking lot, that Merle's is usually the place where you find your card. All right, Cub Scout Pack 3,333. I should be able to remember that number. One of our local Boy Scout groups has been around since 1907. That's older than I am. Promoting youths to be responsible, participating citizens and leaders who are guided by
and
this oath.
Following them is the Red Storm Robotics and Kentwood Public Schools' first robotics program. So FIRST stands for the Inspiration and Recognition of Science and Technology. Has FIRST Lego League teams in most elementary schools, FIRST Tech Challenge teams for middle school students, and FIRST Robotics for high school students. Come join Red Storm.
And here we have Cinema Celebration Cinema, a super icon here in the city of Kentwood. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, watched a movie at Cinema Celebration Cinema yesterday.
Yeah.
Now playing various movies, including the new Indiana Jones adventure. Mm-hmm. Make sure you check it out. And the Barbie movie.
Ah.
Barbie movie.
And
some controversy about that, but it is opening July 21st. And we have
Maurice
Commissioner
Gross. Yes, Maurice Gross is joining us, and he is one of the Kent County Commissioners. We are always thrilled to see him, and he's an incumbent seeking re-election for the Commissioner at Large seat. He'll be running in the primary election August 8th.
In a yellow convertible. What a nice... It looks like a Ford to me.
Does it?
About 1965.
Okay.
And that's part of the commissioner's entourage.
And a 1950s truck there. How fun is that?
That's another Ford. Pink.
Yeah. Is that a Fairlane? No.
And that's a Buick.
Okay.
There is a whole menagerie of antique cars following the commissioner.
Yeah. This is so good.
Okay. We are... smiling at the audience. We really appreciate all of your attention to this.
Yes.
But I need to know, Kathy, an important fact.
What's that?
What day of the year do we eat the most hot dogs?
We eat 1,000,000 hot dogs, 818 hot dogs every second. Wow, that makes my tummy hurt already.
Oh, I hope they're well cooked. Anyway, we have a neighborhood group here, the Surrey Place Friends, who are demonstrating their loyalty, their pride, and their enthusiasm about their neighborhood. We have a couple other groups. So next year, if you have a neighborhood group, you want to get your folks together, we'd love to have you participate in our parade.
Sure.
But Kathy, one of the most important things that we have here at the parade and otherwise at any other gathering is...
we need a mosquito hammer. So we want those mosquitoes gone so we can enjoy. Although with the dryness, it hasn't been bad this year. However, there are certainly mosquitoes to be had.
So if you have a mosquito issue in your backyard or in your gathering place, you know the number to call.
Indeed.
We just saw the Grand Rapids Jeep Club and the history of the Jeeps, as most of you probably have forgotten, goes back to World War II. And in World War II, one of the things that Chrysler Corporation or the Jeep Corporation at that time did was they designed the Jeep so that the windshield would fold down, the tires would come off, and they could put them in the crates, send them over, and they could send a much larger volume of Jeeps over to Europe to fight the battles than the standard vehicles that they had. And here you have a total array of colors and styles that have worked off of the old olive drab Jeeps.
And boy, they do not lack for variety, that's for sure, with color, and certainly look at those red, white, and blue. Absolutely love it.
I hope they're all wearing their seat belts.
I'm sure they are.
And not only hope that they're wearing their seat belts, I hope they have put down their telephones and that they are not using their phones. As you know, the new law came into effect on the 30th of June. So a word of caution out there, folks.
So there are so many wonderful facts of the history of this country, and so let's just touch on a couple of those. So John Adams wrote a letter to his wife Abigail informing him of this new country the Continental Congress had declared independence, and his letter stated, "This day ought to be solemnized with pomp and parade, with shoes, games, sports, guns, bells, bonfires, and illuminations from one end of this continent to the other. And thus we have the beginning of a lot of fireworks."
Fantastic. I'm not sure what he meant about shoes.
Well,
did he want...
Shows, it's S-H-E-W-S. So I'm not sure exactly. Maybe that's the old English for shows. But that's how what was in the letter.
This is an educational program in addition to an entertainment program. So thank you for the tidbit of knowledge. And look at this miniature Jeep.
Yeah, I love it. Start them young.
And we'll have to tell them to drive between the lines, not on the lines. I think that's the conventional way of doing it here in America.
Family includes the dog. I absolutely love this.
And, you know, it warms the cockles of my heart to see the pride that the citizens here in Kentwood have about their country.
Yes.
The troubles that we have had for over 200 or almost 250 years, in 3 years, or 3 years, we will be celebrating the 250th anniversary, and I hope we have a ginger peachy bang dang parade on the 250th day.
We will. In the meantime, let's play some soccer. This is the Kentwood AYSO, a local youth sports program that provides affordable youth soccer focused on fun and player development. Boy, soccer has really increased in this country.
This is a national group that competes not only here in Kentwood, but the teams go all over the United States and maybe even further. These are feeder organizations for the high schools and even the colleges. So if you want tuition grant, a scholarship, play a sport, and soccer is one of the sports. And here we have
Bell Bay Real Estate. It's so wonderful to see the businesses that are joining in, promoting their business, and also being a part of this celebration of the holiday. Where would we be without our Kentwood businesses?
And indeed, it's a professional organization that is well-versed in selling the real estate. Now, we have...
Another mosquito.
Right. If they didn't get it first time around, we have a follow-up group. Mosquito Joe of Grand Rapids makes the outside fun again by eliminating mosquitoes, ticks, and fleas using only natural products so you can safely enjoy your outdoor space.
Love that.
Mosquito Joe offers reoccurring service with no contracts for special events so that you can do your outdoor activity without the ever-biting, irritating pesty mosquitoes.
Yeah.
And they are distributing candy also. Did they know where the host tent is?
They're missing us.
All right.
Jawan Jackson for Kentwood is running for the Kentwood City Commissioner at Large. He is the president of UAW Local 330. He'd like to bring his experience as a labor leader to the Kentwood Commission. The primary election is August 8th.
Make sure you have registered for the election and then make sure you get out and vote. The laws have changed here in Michigan to make it very easy for you to vote absentee or otherwise. So make sure you vote.
Loans of candy going out to all the kids to their delight. Oh, how fun is this? This is Doodler 51.
What a decoration on that car. Mm-hmm. Or SUV. Very unique.
Let us remember part of the Declaration of Independence that we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And boy, we are seeing a lot of happiness out there today.
May I just make a comment on that, Kathy? That when they said, all men are created equal, that was the generic use of the term.
Yes.
It means all people are created. And if you take a look at old literature, the Bible, and so on, you will find that frequently, completely, the term for
man
people was
generic.
Man.
Yes. So and we just saw Lily Cheng Shulting going by, who she is running for Kentwood City Commissioner at Large. Again, the primary is August 8th.
Now, we have the Volunteer Patrol, the VIPs of Kentwood, and they serve a very, very important function here. They are the ones who notify you when you are in a handicap zone or parking in a handicap zone, and they help the police department doing some services such as that, non-law enforcement services. Well, they are law enforcement of sorts.
Okay, and we have the Fourth Form, which is a martial arts group, specializes in karate stick and knife fighting and practical self-defense. We also have another candidate, Ron Dreyer, joining us as well with his group there supporting. So again, August 8th is the election, so we look forward to seeing you at the ballot box. And there we go with the Fourth Form Martial Arts demonstration. A wonderful discipline that it takes to be involved in a sport such as this.
We should mention that Ron Dreyer is currently commissioner in the second ward. He's running for re-election.
He is an incumbent, as is Maurice Gross. This is good. This is good. And look at all the kids. KBSL is with us today. Lots of kids. Kentwood Baseball Softball League is joining us today. So again, another sport that requires discipline and practice and devoted parents to get them there.
Emphasis on devoted parents. Without the parents, these kids would not have the opportunity to play ball, whether hardball, softball, or the like. And mom and dad out there, it's sometimes it becomes a pain to get the kids to practice and to clean their uniforms and even buy some of the equipment.
And then you can grow up to be part of the Kentwood County GOP Republican Committee. And there they are in all their glorious red, white, and blue, representing the voters in Kentwood.
And behind the Kentwood GOP is a Well, let's slip over. This is a model something or other, probably 1938, Etzel Driveway Club, doing their neighborhood thing. And like I said before, these are neighborhood groups who are here demonstrating the loyalty, the pride that they have in their neighborhood, a get-together. And I'll bet you a bunch of them are going to get together for a picnic afterwards. There's going to be hot dogs, brats, and hamburgers all over the place, and even a little bit of potato salad. Mm-hmm. Did you see that blue Chevrolet Corvette?
Yes.
of vintage type? That probably dates back to the, late 60s or early 70s, mm-hmm. or so on. Mm-hmm. Here's another vintage Buick.
Yes.
Roadmaster, and you can tell it's a Roadmaster by those four what look like exhaust things on the side.
Mm, more of the Edsel Driveway Club. You know, I just love, I know that there are so many different thoughts and beliefs out there, but how important it is to this country that we respect each other's views and what each other has to say and stand for. We have got, as a nation, to get it together, to care for each other, and that freedom of speech, that freedom of expression, that is so rare. So hopefully we are, as a country, yeah, we've got our struggles, but we are working to become better as a community, as a country.
Kathy, I can't emphasize that any more than you have. I think the whole concept today and the strife that we have in the political forum, whether it's local or state or federal, and we've seen some real, what I call, ugly guerrilla-type mm-hmm. politics.
And you know, because you've been a government attorney for many, many years. In fact, may I share, 50 years you've been a government attorney, so you certainly have seen it. And I'm fortunate to moderate the Government Matters with WKTV monthly and to have conversation, and how important it is that we have conversation.
Indeed, Kathy, you mentioned the Government Matters. It's on the second Tuesday of every month, on second Monday on WKTV, mm-hmm. and where you have an opportunity to interview numerous elected officials here, not only in the city, county, state, and federal officials who come in to express their opinions. Mm-hmm. Now we have Stassen Electric, a longtime participant in the parade.
Yes.
We look forward to seeing their firecracker and their flag on the truck. And I'll bet you dollars to donuts that's Mr. Stassen driving the truck again.
Yeah.
And we're so grateful and pleased to see him and hope that he continues to participate for a long time in our parade here at Kentwood.
Every Christmas and every 4th he is here. Love it. Established in 1969, it's located on Division Avenue and provides electrical work and services. It's owned by Douglas Stassen.
Meriwether Boxing and Fitness.
Mayweather.
Mayweather, okay. It's all right. I have, my glasses are dirty. Mayweather, that sounds like a well-known name in the boxing industry. And boxing is not only to be aggressive and to beat up on other people, but it does teach the discipline, the physical fitness, and all those other things that are necessary in life.
Yeah, that discipline of mind over body.
And here we have Kentwood Baptist Church, and the churches are such an integral part of the community, mm-hmm. and really of life. And I don't want to say politics, but we learn our morals, we learn our ethics, we learn our Christian heritage by attending church. Not only the Baptist Church necessarily, but all churches. And take a look at the Founding Fathers in the Declaration of Independence, the reference to a deity.
How important. That certainly does bleed into our politics, right?
So, well, we have to be careful to separate church from state, but indeed, the The issue is part of our politics.
I see a dancing praise team from this this church, Kentwood Baptist Church. How fun is that to see the children out there in their costume and ready to dance? And I bet they have been. There they are. Oh, wow. Have we seriously come to the end so soon? That's amazing and went too quickly. And we are just honored to be part of this parade and to be able to give you insight and to be able to view these wonderful folks and groups and churches and businesses and politicians. It all, the whole mix makes us a community in Kentwood. Peter Letzman, it's been a joy to be with you for this brief period of time.
Well, I enjoyed it always, as I frequently do, to work with you, Kathy. And let us not forget, and let us not walk away from the parade and all the festivities and the hot dogs and the balloons and the fireworks and the sparklers and all of those things, that it was on July 4th, 1776, when 56 of our early leaders got together and declared independence of King George III and the tyranny that the British government was visiting on us. And we are celebrating that, even though that we are having some difficult times right now.
We're going to all celebrate today, and we're going to say, God bless America.
Thank you.